Hi, good morning. Welcome to Coffee with a Principal. It is Monday, October 25th. I just want to let you know before we start here, I'm going to be recording this, something I've been wanting to do. I just keep forgetting, but we're going to record this so that we can send it out to any parents who are not able to make it. So just want to let you guys know that this Coffee with a Principal will be recorded today. All right. And we'll be putting that out on our YouTube channel.
Buenos días a todos. Quiero hacerles saber antes que nada que esta reunión se va a grabar. Es algo que he deseado hacer anteriormente, pero les aviso que a partir de esta reunión vamos a estarla grabando y vamos a postearla en el sitio web para todos aquellos padres que por alguna razón no pueden asistir a ella.
All right, welcome to Monday. We're having a little spirit week this week. Just to start off, this week is a dress-up week for our secondary students. Today is Halloween colors. Tomorrow, a ghost out. That means wearing all white. Wednesday, witch versus zombies. Kids are dressing up as witches or zombies. Thursday, an interesting one here, is called bring everything but your backpack. So what we do there is kids can bring something else to carry all their belongings in, whatever else that might be. They can get creative. I saw another school do this, and a kid brought a wheelbarrow, and he pushed everything around in a wheelbarrow during the day. So we'll see how that goes and how students get creative. And then Friday is wearing a costume. As we reminded students this morning on our announcements at 8:30 when school started, any costume that's worn, students do need to keep their face. A mask cannot cover the entirety of their face, which is a little awkward in today's age since we have a mask anyway that covers the nose down. But we did remind students of that policy just for safety. So with that being said, Spirit Week this week, that'll be a fun thing going on. A couple other things going on, just so that you know, you're aware of it as parents. We've got, sorry, Patty, I'll let you translate that.
Thank you. Sí, les comentamos que esta semana tenemos la semana del espíritu briefing para la secundaria. Entonces, esta semana, el día de hoy, los chicos tenían que venir vestidos con colores relacionados con Halloween. El día de mañana tienen que venir con algo representativo de los fantasmas. El día miércoles va a ser brujas contra zombies. El día jueves es traigan todo excepto su mochila. So vamos a ver qué tan creativos son los estudiantes. Tiene que traer sus útiles en cualquier cosa que no sea su mochila. De hecho, esta idea la vi en otra escuela y un chico trajo sus útiles en un barril. Vamos a ver qué es lo que nuestros chicos hacen. El día viernes va a ser el día de disfraces. Los muchachos van a poder venir disfrazados de lo que ellos quieran. Pero sé que suena raro, ¿verdad? Pero no deben de traer la cara totalmente cubierta, a pesar de que la máscara ya nos cubre la mitad de la cara, ¿verdad? Pero esto es lo que está pasando esta semana con la escuela secundaria. Thank you, Mr. Ford.
Thank you, Patty. Again, those who are just coming in, we do want to let you know that this recording, we are recording this. I'm going to put it out on our YouTube channel for parents to be able to watch it later. So just want to let you know about that. You will not be on that video unless you have your camera on and you speak. So, just so that you're aware. A couple other things. December 11th, our ASB is working on a winter formal dance on December 11th. That'll be right here on campus following all COVID-19 guidelines and regulations. But again, December 11th, that's a Saturday. It will be in the evening. ASB students are in charge of this event. There will be dancing outside. That's the only thing that can happen. It is going to be cold. They're working on heaters, et cetera, to be out there. And then there will be, the gym will be open for students to have some refreshments, all prepackaged items for COVID guidelines, and also a chance to get out of the cold at that time. But the kids really want to have a dance. And so again, winter formal coming up on December 11th, they're hammering that out and they'll start to advertise that when they are ready to. November 19th, we're going to have a pep rally right here on campus. That'll be out on our field for the entire middle school, high school, November, again, 19th. That's the day before Thanksgiving break. We're gonna have a pep rally at the end of school to celebrate everything that's going on. And again, ASB kids are running that pep rally. So excited about those couple of things coming up for our students. A couple other, our first quarter grades went out. You should have received an update on first quarter grades. Remember, at the secondary level here, the whole year is broken up into four quarters. So that first quarter is done. And then now we are in the second quarter. It's broken up into four quarters, two semesters. So the first semester is until Christmas break, from August until Christmas break. That's the grade that goes on your child's transcript, okay? That's the long-lasting grade that they'll have forever. In fact, I just found my freshman report card, and that was fun, at my mom's house. I don't know why she kept it all these years, but freshman report card from 1990. And my son right now is a freshman, and he loves seeing that he has much better grades than dad did. But that semester grade that comes out in December is the one that lasts forever. And then, of course, next semester is called the spring semester. That's broken down into the third and fourth quarter. Okay. Go ahead, Patty.
Thank you. Give me a second. Okay. Para los padres que se acaban de unir a nosotros en esta reunión, les hacemos saber que se está grabando esta sesión para poder ponerla en el canal que tenemos de YouTube. Obviamente no van a aparecer sus rostros ni sus voces si ustedes no participan y no lo permiten. Les comentamos que para el día 11 de diciembre se está planeando el baile de invierno. Los estudiantes son quienes lo están organizando. Esto se realizará, como les comentaba, el sábado en la noche, diciembre 11, los estudiantes tendrán el baile afuera en el patio. Están buscando en este momento formas de mantenerse no tan fríos. Están buscando calentadores y a ver qué opciones pueden encontrar para poder estar cómodamente. También se tendrá abierto el gimnasio para que tengan algún tipo de refrigerio los muchachos. Ya estarán haciendo la publicidad y los anuncios correspondientes cuando estén listos. También les comentamos que se va a llevar a cabo el día 19 de noviembre el Pep Rally aquí en nuestras instalaciones. También este evento está siendo organizado por los estudiantes. En información independiente les comento que el año escolar está dividido en cuatro cuartos, lo que es equivalente a dos semestres. En este momento nosotros estamos en el segundo semestre. Las calificaciones, en cuanto estén listas, serán las que aparecerán en su boleta, serán calificaciones finales. De hecho, yo encontré, mi mamá tenía guardado mi boleta de calificaciones de cuando yo era un freshman, en el año 1990, y mi hijo está muy contento de ver que él tiene mucho mejores calificaciones que las que yo tenía en ese momento. En la primavera empezaremos con el tercer cuarto, y después continuaremos con el último. Thank you, Mr. Ford.
Very good. So at this time, with those couple announcements, we'd love to open it up for any questions you may have. Again, for those just coming in, we are recording this session so we can get it out to parents who are not able to make this. You will not be on that recorded session unless you are on video. So if you don't want to be on video, no problem. Just keep yourself as a black box as you ask questions. You can ask any questions about what's going on here at the Academy, either in the chat or out loud verbally. So, Patty, if you could translate that, and we'll get going.
Yes, of course. Nuevamente, los padres que se están uniendo en este momento, les hacemos saber que estamos grabando esta sesión para todos aquellos padres que no pueden asistir en este momento, la puedan ver después. Si no quieren aparecer en el video, pueden mantener su pantalla oscura, ¿verdad? Y si tienen alguna pregunta, por favor, háganlo ya sea por medio del chat o de voz. Solamente queríamos empezar esta mañana con los anuncios que ya les comentamos, pero estamos listos para cualquier pregunta que tengan ustedes. Thank you, Mr. Ford.
Questions, preguntas. Who's going to be first? Any questions you may have?
Cualquier pregunta que tengan, ¿quién será primero?
Are there any plans to open the H building ahead here now that the weather is turning? Yes, yes, we are. Today we have plans for that to happen. H building opens every morning at 7:30 now that we have classes in there for zero period credit recovery. So our H building does open when campus opens at 7:30. The hangar is open at this time. During lunch, we've got some special education students in there. During the lunchtime, some of those students are ones who have anxiety or other issues to the point they don't like being out with the entirety of the school campus at lunchtime. So those things are open at this time.
Preguntaba una mamá si se iba a abrir el edificio, el hangar, ahora que está cambiando el clima. Dice el señor Ford que sí, de hecho ya está abierto. Se abre a las 7:30 para el periodo cero, para los estudiantes que quieran asistir o que necesiten asistir. También está abierto a la hora del almuerzo para aquellos estudiantes que tengan algún tipo de ansiedad o que simplemente no se sientan cómodos estando fuera en el patio, si ya está abierto el hangar.
Last time we met, folks, there were a lot of questions about the afternoon supper, and you'll see we've put the answer to that here. It's going to start in about a week, November 1st, for all students participating in after-school programs, athletics, clubs. The after-school supper will be kick-starting again here on November 1st, as long as that gets approval tonight at our board meeting. That will be going before the board. And so that'll be starting November 1st again.
La reunión anterior había muchas preguntas sobre la cena, si se iba a proporcionar a los estudiantes la cena. Sí, a menos de que se diga lo contrario en la junta que tendremos hoy con la mesa directiva. Ya se tiene programado que a partir de noviembre primero, los estudiantes que se quedan para programas extraescolares como athletics y los clubes, empiecen a recibir su cena a partir de noviembre primero.
Question about how's the library coming along? Will it be open to all grades? The school does not have a library at this time. Something that we're discussing, but there's no plans right now at all to report back on a library. Any update on vaccines for students? No update that the Academy has for that. I know that that's a real sensitive topic for most parents, but we will follow at this time. What I can say is we will follow whatever state mandate comes down from California Department of Public Health. But at this time, we have no update on that at all.
Preguntaban cómo iba la posibilidad de abrir una biblioteca. En este momento no tenemos biblioteca disponible en la escuela. También preguntaban si hay alguna actualización en cuanto a la vacunación. No, tampoco tenemos ninguna actualización al respecto, simplemente que estamos siguiendo las instrucciones y regulaciones por parte del Estado.
Any updates on construction next door? No updates on anything next door at this time.
Preguntan si hay alguna actualización en cuanto a la construcción que se va a hacer al lado de la escuela. No, tampoco tenemos hasta el momento ninguna actualización en relación con este tema.
Question about with the hangar not accessible to most students or the other plans. We're trying to make that accessible for more students. It's a matter of being able to have more classified staff here to help with that management during the school day during lunch. So we hope to change that very soon. Update about hiring teachers. Yes, we are lacking an eighth grade math teacher. We interviewed an eighth grade math teacher Friday. We had panel interviews for that and hope to move forward with a job offer there for that eighth grade math spot. Still have a couple of STEM, science, technology, engineering, math, still have a couple of STEM positions open that we've not received an application for over the course of at least the last 8 weeks. So we are moving forward to try to access that. Yes, there's quite a few different e-libraries. James Henry asked about students have access to that. They do have access to quite a few different e-libraries that the school has. Ms. Patty?
Yeah. Si preguntaban si hay forma de que el hangar esté abierto por más tiempo, estamos tratando de hacer eso, simplemente que se necesita más personal para poder mantenerlo abierto durante más tiempo. Preguntaban también sobre la contratación de maestros. Se acaba de hacer la contratación de una maestra de matemáticas para el octavo grado el viernes. Todavía estamos esperando para contratar maestros para ciencias y STEM. Estamos checando todas las aplicaciones recibidas. También nos preguntan, nos comentan si hay acceso al e-library y si efectivamente la escuela tiene acceso a e-library.
Looks like Anna Mena has her hand up. Anna, thanks for your patience.
Mi pregunta es, mi hijo, no sé qué está pasando en la escuela, pero mi hijo me está diciendo que casi todos sus maestros son sustitutos. O sea, ¿por qué no hay maestros o por qué no están sus maestros que son de cada clase?
Mrs. Mena's son is telling mom that most of the teachers he has are substitutes. So mom wants to know what's going on, why there are not, main teachers, and why is the student having most of in his classes substitutes? What's happening with that?
Sure, good question. So right now we've got, I'll walk down our list of substitutes that we have for you, because we've got about 70 teachers. We've got two teachers that are out with babies, either pregnant or have just had babies, so they're out with their baby bonding time. And then we've got four other teachers, four teaching vacancies, one in math that I just referred to. We finally had some candidates for that position and we did those interviews Friday. And then we've got a special ed position open still. Got two candidates for that last week, and we have some interviews on that actually tomorrow. And then we have two STEM positions. So we started this school year with five teaching vacancies. We've filled one of those this year so far and hope to get the rest of these filled very soon. Again, we have not had a STEM teaching applicant for a couple of months now, unfortunately. And we've just received some math and SPED teaching applications and are going through that process of getting some of them interviewed. So again, we've got those two, they're called long-term subs, two long-term subs for a couple of employees out with babies. And then we've got these four vacant positions still. So out of our approximately 70 teachers, we do have six out right now, long-term wise.
Tenemos, perdón, aproximadamente 70 maestros. De esos 70 maestros, en este momento, dos de ellos se encuentran fuera por maternidad. Tenemos ahorita vacantes para maestros de STEM, también para educación especial. Tenemos dos posiciones, como les comentaba, para STEM, que aún no han sido llenadas. Tenemos, como les comenté también, acabamos de contratar un maestro de matemáticas. Tenemos dos sustitutos de tiempo completo. Tenemos todavía cuatro vacantes disponibles, pero vamos a tener entrevistas esta semana para algunos candidatos, para cubrir algunas de estas posiciones.
I have a question here. My daughter said they're not allowed to walk around the school while at lunch. Said they are mandated to stay in three areas only, limiting where they can gather. They were able to walk around prior to COVID. When will they be able to have access to more areas? The entire campus is open outside of the following area, okay? Outside of the following areas. And this is a change since I became the principal. We no longer allow the students to walk next to the classrooms where there are kids in class. And so, for instance, at middle school bridge time, middle school bridge high school students are at lunch, and then flip-flop that when high school students are in bridge, middle school students are at lunch. So before there was no limitation on walking around what's called the T building here. Kids were just allowed to walk around the T building right next to classes that have students in them for that bridge time, intervention time, okay? We've closed that off. So they're not allowed to walk all around the buildings where students are in class for intervention. That's the only change that's been made since prior to COVID. So the entire campus is open outside of the hallways here at the T building. And then they're not allowed to go in the H building, again, because there's classes happening there during lunch times. So those are the only changes that have been made. I don't think, and our teachers don't think, it's good to have students walking right next to these classes where there's interventions and bridge time happening. So that's the one change that we have made.
Sí, preguntaba una mamá. Su hija le comentó que no le es permitido caminar en cualquier área de la escuela a la hora de su almuerzo. Solamente tiene tres áreas disponibles de acuerdo con este estudiante. Entonces preguntaba la razón. Dice el señor Ford que la totalidad del campus está abierto para los estudiantes con excepción del edificio H y el edificio T. La razón es porque cuando los estudiantes de la escuela secundaria están en su almuerzo, los estudiantes de la escuela preparatoria aún están en clases y viceversa. Entonces, para no distraer a esos estudiantes, esa es la única restricción que se tiene. No pueden caminar cerca del edificio T ni pueden entrar al edificio H durante el almuerzo para no distraer a los estudiantes que aún están en clase. De ahí en fuera, ellos tienen la libertad de caminar en cualquier otra área.
Ms. Melger, does that make sense? I hope that makes sense as far as your question goes. The only place that's been limited is them walking next to the T building upstairs, downstairs. It's called the T building classrooms. And then inside the H building because there's classes happening.
Sí, esperamos que esta respuesta haya sido satisfactoria para la señora Melger. Dice ella que sí. Gracias.
What else? Any other questions about anything happening here at the academy?
¿Alguna otra pregunta en relación con la academia?
I just have a comment. Thank you so much for having these meetings. They're really informative. I always look forward to checking in to see what's going on. And Patty, you are a super awesome translator.
Thank you so much. You make my day, my week, my whole rest of the year. Appreciate it.
I don't know how you get every word. You must do like perfect dictation or something, but really good work.
Thank you. Thank you very much. Appreciate it. Nos da las gracias a la señora Celita. Dice que aprecia mucho estas reuniones porque nos da mucha información y también le da las gracias a su servidora. Dice que hago un buen trabajo. Gracias. Muchas gracias.
Yeah, thank you, Patty. A question about where they're going to rain. Luckily, we haven't had that issue yet this year, but we will today. It's going to rain by 1 o'clock. And so when it does rain, first of all, we've asked all of our teachers to just be flexible, open all of their classrooms before school at lunch if they're able to. We also have the hangar will be open today, specifically at lunch. We're going to, because we won't need the supervision outdoors, we're going to repost some of our campus supervisors around, and then also the gym will be open as well as a cafeteria. So we just have to move things around today so that kids have some indoor spaces.
Y preguntaban que qué va a suceder en caso de que llueva. Dice el señor Ford que le va a pedir a los maestros que sean flexibles en cuanto a permitir a los estudiantes que lo deseen quedarse en sus salones. Se va a abrir el hangar también, el gimnasio y la cafetería. Solamente necesitamos que los supervisores de campo estén al pendiente de todas estas áreas.
So question here, a direct message. We would like that senior parents be informed of everything you are planning. The parent who sent that, I'm not sure if you're at the senior parent meeting we had about 3 weeks ago that kind of gave an overview of the entire year for seniors. And then that was recorded and sent out to parents as well. If I don't want to say the name here since you direct messaged me, but if you did not receive that recording, if you were not there, please email myself. I will get that recording out to you about the overview for the seniors. We did have that senior parent night, and we'll get that out. We'll get that out to you if you did not come to that.
Comentaba un padre de familia que considera que los padres de seniors necesitan estar informados sobre lo que está sucediendo en la escuela. Dice el señor porque aún tenemos 3 semanas para poder comentar al respecto, pero de cualquier manera se hizo una grabación con toda la información pertinente a este asunto y le pide a este padre que comparta su correo electrónico para que se le mande ese video con todos los detalles en él.
Yeah, you'll see my assistant, Minister Hetha, in on 10/28, so that's this Thursday. There will be a financial aid overview for by our counseling, financial aid overview for all senior parents. And that's in conjunction with Alicia Vieira, one of our counselors. Miss Vieira is also a counselor at Antelope Valley College. That'll be happening this Thursday.
Y preguntaban si iba a haber algún tipo de taller relacionado con el apoyo económico para los estudiantes. Nos comenta el señor porque el día jueves se va a llevar a cabo uno de esos talleres aquí en la escuela con la ayuda y colaboración de la señora Alicia Vieira, quien también trabaja en el Antelope Valley College. So, para cualquier padre que esté interesado, vamos a tener este taller el día jueves.
Anything else? Anything else to discuss, folks? Oh, a question from Ms. Kaur. Sorry, I missed this one up here. What grade is the winter formal? What grade is it? So our ASB students are the ones putting on that winter formal, and they're still discussing. It will be a high school dance. They're still discussing if that's going to be open to just juniors and seniors or all freshmen through senior. So that'll be a decision ASB students make.
Y preguntaba a una mamá para qué grados va a ser el baile de invierno. Lo están platicando todavía los estudiantes AP, si va a ser solamente para junior y seniors o si también van a incluir a los freshmen, pero está por definirse.
Not as many questions this time.
No tenemos muchas preguntas en esta ocasión.
Will my son be offered robotics in a later time? So our middle school, robotics for the middle school is happening on Tuesdays. That's a club. Middle school robotics on Tuesdays is happening, and a high school's robotics team has been up and running for months. Miss Lisa Perry oversees that. As a regular high school class, not this year. We did launch that this year. We started a brand new robotics class during the day for high school students. The goal of that was to get our robotics students who are on our competitive robotics team into that class, and then have our robotics director teach that class. Unfortunately, we weren't able to find a robotics director. By the time school started, Miss Lisa Perry has kind of helped to oversee that now at this time. But we hope to find a long-term solution for a director of robotics. We'll see if that happens this next hiring process.
Y en cuanto al taller de robótica, los estudiantes de la secundaria tienen este taller como un club los días martes. En cuanto a los estudiantes de la escuela preparatoria, esta clase se les está dando como una clase regular, la está dando la maestra Lisa Perry. Y la razón por la que hicimos esto es que estábamos buscando un director encargado del área de robótica, pero desafortunadamente no hemos podido conseguirlo, por eso es que no tenemos el club como tal para la escuela preparatoria, pero sí la maestra Lisa Perry se está encargando en este momento de tener esa clase con los estudiantes de la escuela preparatoria.
All right, I just called our yearbook director here, our yearbook teacher, on the question here regarding senior pictures from Monica. What he said is O'Connor and William Edwards is sending him the files for all the senior pictures, and he needs them no later than November 5th. So it looks like that's a couple of weeks here on senior pictures still, November 5th.
Y pregunta a una mamá si es muy tarde para que su estudiante a graduar pueda tomarse sus fotografías. Dice el maestro encargado del anuario que espera tener todas las fotografías no más tardar de noviembre 5. Por lo que si necesitan tomar esas fotos, se les recomienda hacerlo lo más pronto posible. La fecha límite es noviembre 5.
All right, I had a great question here and a direct message that probably a lot of parents are wondering about what this process looks like. I'll read the question to you, not saying the name of the parent who sent it, obviously, here. My daughter is struggling in one class, and according to her, many more students are also having trouble with huge drops in their grades in that one class. What is the best advice you can give us parents? Talk directly to the teacher, ? But my daughter doesn't want to feel intimidated if I email the teacher directly. That's a common thing we deal with, maybe, you know, 3, 4, 5 times a week. We get these kind of questions from parents, and we always say yes. The best course of action is to go directly to the teacher, not about the other students' grades in the class, not to go to them with, hey, we understand most kids are having a tough time in here. Just keep it about your own child. You know, I'm wondering why my child has a C or a D or whatever that grade is. What can he or she do to improve this grade? We always encourage folks to be active in PLUS portals so that you can keep up on your child's grade. If there's not communication back from the teacher that's acceptable to you, then please get administration, please get me involved so we can help that communication. We have parent teacher conferences often. Sometimes those also include an administrator if that communication is not going well. But please feel like if you do reach out to your child's teacher about their grade, as long as you keep it simply to their grade and not an accusatory nature, like, hey, I hear all of your students are having a trouble in here. You know, if you don't say that and you keep it to your child's grade, we hope that the teachers wouldn't be retaliatory in any way, like what you're saying here. If they are, if your child feels like they've been targeted or something like that after you bring up the grade issue, then we need to get administration involved. That's what I would do as a parent. You know, Patty, go ahead.
Sí, tenemos una pregunta de un padre que no vamos a decir su nombre. Nos pregunta qué pasa si alguno de sus estudiantes está batallando con calificaciones muy bajas, que por alguna razón su calificación bajó. ¿Cuál sería el consejo para este padre de familia? El señor Ford nos dice que esta pregunta la tienen 3, 4, hasta 5 veces a la semana. La mejor forma de tratar esta situación es comunicarse directamente con el maestro del estudiante, ¿verdad? Y preguntarle, no en forma general, no hablando del grupo, no decir por qué el grupo está bajo en calificaciones, simplemente refiriéndose a su estudiante en particular. Me gustaría saber por qué mi hijo, mi hija tiene una C, una D o la calificación que ustedes consideren que necesita ser clarificada. ¿Y cómo podría mejorar esa calificación? Esperando que el maestro, por supuesto, les dé una respuesta satisfactoria. De no ser así, entonces ustedes pueden pedirle al señor Ford que se involucre en esta situación. Y si es necesario, también alguien más de la administración podría tomar cartas en el asunto. Pero sí les pedimos que su comunicación con el maestro, la maestra, sea de forma amable, agradable, y que se dirija realmente solamente enfocándose a su estudiante, no generalizando, ¿verdad? Ahora, si su estudiante siente que es personal, digamos, la situación, nuevamente el señor Ford nos dice que nos pongamos en contacto con alguien de la administración para poder dar la atención debida a esta situación.
Sure. Good question here from a parent in another direct message. It's a little unclear to me what bridge class is for. Could you clarify? So bridge class happens. Every student has bridge. That Miss Anna Mena, you know what? I'm going to go to Anna Mena and then I'll come back to bridge because she's had her hand up here. And I apologize for not getting you. Miss Mena?
Mi pregunta es... ¿Cómo están o sea, así como están las cosas ahorita, que en todos lados están exigiendo la vacuna, la escuela les va a exigir a los estudiantes que se vacunen, o sea, la vacuna para estar en la escuela?
Mrs. Mena wants to know if the school is going to demand, is it going to be mandatory for the students to get vaccinated?
The school, as we have done all along, the school will be following the California Department of Public Health on any type of mandate. So that will come from them and we will follow what all schools have to follow, but there's no information at this time on that vaccination.
Señora Mena, nosotros seguimos a las instrucciones del Departamento de Salud del Estado de California. Hasta este momento no han dado ese mandato, por lo que si no es emitido, no lo vamos a exigir. Como le digo, seguimos esos lineamientos y ellos son los que nos informan qué se debe hacer. Hasta el momento no se ha emitido ese mandato.
Ok.
All right, a little unclear about Bridge. Great question, especially if you're newer to the academy. Bridge is a time for intervention. What intervention means is what help assistance do our students need to do better in different subjects, in math or English, science, history, whatever the subject matter is. And so every student on campus, grades 6 to 12, have a bridge class. That bridge happens, for instance, during middle school from 1256 to 141, for high school from 101, high school from 1216 to 101. So every student has a bridge class of between 25 to 30 students. And bridge is handled a little differently per grade level. The teachers are in bridge teams. So the seventh grade bridge team, eighth grade bridge team, ninth grade bridge team, et cetera. And the teacher bridge teams handle things a little different per grade level. Go ahead, Patty.
Y nos preguntaban cuál es la función de la clase de bridge. La clase de bridge es un tiempo de intervención para ayudar a los estudiantes para mejorar sus calificaciones en la materia que lo necesiten. Por lo que cada estudiante desde el grado 6 hasta el grado 12 tiene que tener su clase de bridge. Dio los horarios, pero solo pude agarrar uno, que es de la escuela preparatoria de 12:16 a la 1 de la tarde. Tenemos de 25 a 30 estudiantes por grupo. Los maestros trabajan por equipos y manejan, van por grado. Tenemos maestros de Rich para el grado 7, para el grado 8 y así sucesivamente. Thank you, Mr. Ford.
So again, that's a time period of 40 minutes per day where students receive extra help and assistance depending on where they need that. Teachers just recently on October 4th, our data day, our student free data day, teachers were given the current data and assessments on every student, specifically in math and English, as those assessments have happened through our testing, and help determine which students needed extra work in which classes. One of the other things that happens in our bridge time on Fridays, every student, when they graduate from the academy, they are to have what's called a school to career master plan. And so on Fridays, all of our teachers have lessons for every single Friday throughout the course of this year to help our students with that school to career master plan development and portfolio. Every teacher has autonomy as to how they teach that and exactly what that looks like in their classrooms.
Sí, nos dice el señor Ford que en la clase de bridge son 40 minutos por día a partir del día de octubre 4, que fue día libre para los estudiantes. Los maestros estuvieron aquí. Se les entregaron los resultados de las evaluaciones de cada uno de los estudiantes para que ellos pudieran determinar en qué materia es que el alumno necesita más ayuda. También se nos informa que los días viernes en la clase de bridge se tiene un plan maestro para determinar la carrera que sería más conveniente para el estudiante. Se les ayuda a desarrollar un portafolio. Cada maestro tiene su propia forma de hacerlo, pero sí tenemos este tiempo obligatorio todos los viernes para poder ayudar al estudiante con la determinación de la carrera a estudiar.
Yes, follow-up question was, are they allowed to go to a teacher they are struggling with bridge? Yeah, that's exactly the idea. Again, this happens a little differently throughout each grade level. Sixth grade, seventh grade, for instance, have very detailed dialed-in plans where they basically assign the students where to go based on their most current assessments. And then in other grade levels, it's exactly what the question we just got here was. Can they, for instance, last Thursday, I was out subbing in one of our bridge classes, and a couple of students said, hey, we've got a biology test. Three students came up and said, can we go over and see our biology teacher? And so I just chatted that biology teacher. Hey, these three students want to come over to study for the biology test coming up this week. Can they do that? It was yes, of course, send them on over. So that's another reason. That's another thing that happens during the course of bridge class is that students can go seek the help and attention of whichever course they are maybe struggling in at the moment or preparing for a test, etc.
Sí, tenemos organizado que los estudiantes de sexto y séptimo grado, por ejemplo, tienen un programa muy detallado donde a los maestros les indican a estos estudiantes a qué clase ir para pedir esa ayuda extra que necesitan. El resto de los grupos, por ejemplo, el jueves pasado estaba yo en una clase cuando tres estudiantes se acercaron y me comentaron que iban a tener un examen de biología. Yo querían saber si podían ir con la maestra respectiva para poder estudiar un poco más, por lo que yo llamé a esa maestra, le pregunté si estos estudiantes podían ir a buscar la ayuda necesaria y por supuesto que la respuesta fue que sí. Entonces los estudiantes tienen esa libertad de saber en qué área es donde necesitan la ayuda y pedirla.
We've got about 14 more minutes here. If there's any other further questions about anything going on.
Tenemos aproximadamente 14 minutos más para terminar esta reunión. ¿Hay alguna otra pregunta?
¿Alguna más? Anything more?
¿Algo más?
Is it algo? Did I say it wrong, Patty? ¿Alguna?
¿Algo más? ¿Alguna duda?
All right, we're going to wrap this up then. If there's no other questions coming in, we'll give you about two more minutes here. And then we'll wrap things up.
Si no hay alguna otra duda, comentario, vamos entonces a terminar en un par de minutos.
Nothing more. All right, folks. Thank you for being here. We certainly appreciate you investing this last hour with us. As always, I'll put my email address here in the chat. If there's anything at all we can do to better serve you or your children or child, please don't hesitate to reach out with any of those ideas or concepts, okay? Thanks so much. And I'm going to stop the recording now. And we will see you guys next time. Thank you.
Gracias a todos por